One morning, Mama Stutzinger went for a walk. He went past the trees of Kringleford Park. And then he went into the library.
One of the things that comes up time and time and time again on our show is
a book called Pinocchio. The trees of Kringleford Park and back into the comfort of Mumba Stuntsinger's very own home. Then Mumba Stuntsinger realised he had a cough. So he went out of his house through the trees of Kringleford Park to the chemist. Mumba Stuntsinger bought some cough syrup. He came out of the chemist through the trees of Kringleford Park to Mumba Stuntsinger's very own home. Mumba Stuntsinger sat reading his book as happy as can be.
I am not
Harry,
recording!
Now let's get one thing straight.
I'm not bloody well recording.
No, even so. But you get one thing straight. You record your stuff and...
Sorry I'm late. Anyway, welcome to Where Is It Anyway? Well, today we are going to be exploring my bedroom and my mum's bedroom and this room here. Take a look around now. If you know where that is, if you've looked really carefully, you should know where this is now. No peeking. Do you know where that is? If you did, cool. 765-655 now. Details will be coming up at the end of the programme. Now, into my room. At last, in my room. Well, have a close look now. Look at this. If you were to have examined this room carefully, you should know where this is. Just if you do, call it the same number as I said a minute ago. Now, into Mum's room. Room. Did you see that? Well, here we go. If you've examined that carefully, you should know where this is. Well, if you do, you've got the same number as a minute ago. This is not the end. Look on your dressing table. Go have a look on your chairs. Go have a look on your windowsills. Go have a look everywhere. Go have a look in your hallway. Go have a look in your bedroom. Everywhere, everywhere look everywhere to see if you can find the same places I just showed you. Remember, 065-655. Now, bye-bye.
That's the end.
And this is our fan. Mum?
Yeah?
Hello and welcome to Where the Hell Am I? Today I will be taking you through a range of rooms and all you've got to do is guess where the thing I show is. Simple really, isn't it? Well, let's start with the first room in the house, the middle room. If you would like to take a look around and use your brain. Oh, let's have a look around the house. Oh, let's have a delightful little look. Oh, wasn't that nice, ladies and gentlemen? Now, can you guess where this is? Guessed where that was. Could you dial 765-655 now? Now you're going to the second. No, actually, we're going to do the second puzzle in this room. All you've got to do is guess what's different when you look around the room the second time. Here we go. We're going to have a nice little look around the room now, yet again. This could be a decent hint for the other. Question can. All you've got to do is remember what's here, what's where, what's everywhere. Now I'm going to show you something that could be different the second time round. Now we're having our second look around the room. If you notice anything different from last time, please give us a call on 765-655. It is quite easy, but then again, it's ding, ding, ding. Where the hell am I anyway? Bye for now. See you in my bedroom. Oh. Well, I finally got back to my room, and now we're in for our second task of winning £25. Well, as we come over here, we're going to have just one little look around the room, and guess where the camera is. That was a nice look, wasn't it? Let's just go back around the room once more. Can you guess where this is? If you know, please send your name and address on a postcard to 32 Wood Street, Norwich, Norfolk, whatever, whatever, whatever. Thank you. And we will have our second game in a couple of seconds. Now, take a decent look around the room. This could give you a hint for the first game, like I always say. Find what's missing the second time round and I will give you £25. It's a decent saying, isn't it? Oh look, there's a window, it's decent, isn't it? Well, that was a nice look round. Guess what the hell has called us from the last time that you had a look around the room?
It's quite difficult, but don't delay. You might be very, very gay. If you phone up 765-655, you could win 25. Whatever, 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 whatever. Let's just take one last look around. Well, let's go to our third and final room. Yep, you guessed it. It's Mummy's room. And take a nice look around the room, because I'm going to be asking you some questions on it. Where the bloody hell am I?
Beep, 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 bing, ding, dang, dong.
Well, if you have got any bloody idea where that stupid little tiger person was, please give me a ring on 765-655. Now for the second game, which is really, really difficult. We're going to have a look around the room and see what is gone the next time you have a look around your bum. Nice day today, don't you think?
Oh yes, very nice indeed. Ooh, look at that picture, it's decent, isn't it? Right, that was fun, wasn't it? Guess where I am now?
If you have got any idea where I was pointing, well, has disappeared the second time I looked around the room, please give us a call on 765-655. And always remember, look behind your curtains, there could be a bear hidden under the bed, there could be a head, and even when you're feeling sad and low.
Hello? Sorry I'm late, again. I'm always late on time. It must be that dreadful old wife. Anyway, today we are going to be searching the room around here, which is the front room. We'll be searching Harry's room up there and the kitchen along the hallway. Well, starting off with this room, have a little search around this room. Well, if you've examined that really closely, you'll know where this is. No peeking. Yeah, do you know where that is? Cool. 765-655 now. But details will be coming up at the end of the programme. Okay, now, on to the kitchen. Hello, welcome to the kitchen. Where another one of our, where is it anyway, will be done. Okay, here you go. Search. Anyway, you should have been examining that really hard. Well, where is it anyway? Up to the bedroom. At last, we're in the bedroom. As you can see, Another time I've got to ask to have a little search about. Hello again.
Well, while you're having us think about that, I want to introduce you to my pet snake. His name.
Mum! Okay then. Well, now you've had a little think. Where is it anyway? I'm back. Well, I would like to say that is the end. Oops, I mean, I'm sad to say this is the end. If you know that, remember to ring 765-655 now. But remember to ask permission for the person who pays the bill before you dial. Thank you. But you haven't seen the ending yet, have you? A show's not complete without the ending. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, go. Shuma nani. Look. Ya. Television sets. Look on your high shelves. Look on your bunk beds. Look everywhere. Look on the floor. Well, here we go. Yeah! Look in your hallway. Yeah, look in your bedrooms. Yeah, look everywhere now. Yeah, look at yourself in the mirror. Look at the bed. Woo! Look at the beds. Look round the side of your beds. As well, look around in the dressing table. Look around on your exercise machine. Look around on your brother's head. Da, 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 da. Damn. Bye from me.
Bye from him. Bye bye.
No hands.
Isn't that amazing, ladies and gentlemen?
No hands.
Alex Clark is playing with no hands. How do they do that?
It's an action replay. But shh. This is me really playing. Sloppy mud, sloppy mud. Ease off on the accelerator a bit, Alex. And down, put your foot down. Ease off. Brake. Sludgy mud, sludge mud.
He's on. Let's go for a ride. Sloppy, sloppy, muddy, mud.
Alice has milk chocolate. That's chocolate-ized, liquid-ized. Well, is that a decent course? Look at that big patch of bum holes.
Sloppy, sloppy chocolate. Sloppy, slop, slop.
What the hell is he? Look, he's zooming around the track.
Final lap! Let's go for a ride.
Let's go for some fun lessons, baby.
Let's go for some driving lessons, baby.
Oh, God, it's that sloppy, sloppy chocolate.
As you can see, I made it in 1 minute 51.85 seconds.
How many? Oh, yeah, you're right.
I might
do a decent Bowser course.
Anyway, now I'll let you choose the courses. Which course, viewers?
Vanilla Lake, please, Mr. Alex.
That one? Good.
Oh,
okay,
yes,
then.
Please.
Here we go. Vanilla Lake.
Which way, viewers?
Forward march.
Oh, right, please, Mr. Alec.
Yeah, yeah.
Where the hell is he?
This is very hard, viewers.
Yes, did you know?
Very hard, man.
Wait, I'll swap the camera for the controls. It's decent. This is probably the easiest whole level.
Probably the hardest one. It may look easy, but it's not.
Well, everyone at home thinks it's easy. I've had about 10 million phone calls.
Well, well, next time we'll get someone on the show.
Yeah, good idea.
I know who it's going to be.
Who?
Harry, this is you. This is where you're going to be next week, same time.
Same place on BBC Two.
But remember, don't tell Mother.
Alex, what the hell are you talking about?
That's what it says on Toonatics. Yeah, remember that, viewers.
But remember, don't tell Mother. Oh, bloody hell, this is difficult, isn't it?
Well, viewers, do you want to see me going on my last little run? Whee!
Look at that little cloud, isn't it decent?
Do you like me spinning around like that? I can do another one if you want.
No, please don't.
Okay, I'll do one near the end, though.
What is that thing's problem? And he's finished. Where are you?
As you can see, who wants to choose another one?
Wait up. I'd zoomed in on this telly. Where the hell is the telly? Oh, there it is. Right, change course, definitely.
Okay, which one?
Bowser, you film, get it?
Okay, film. Bowser.
Film. Hope you're better than me.
Now,
see, this is what how a pro do it.
Yeah.
Oh, bloody hell, I didn't want to skid. Oh, yes, this is how the pros do it, if you're stupid enough not to think I'm a pro. Oh, shit, I thought it was a different course.
As you can see, ladies and gentlemen, and Harry Clark.
Thank you very much.
He's quite good, but not good enough.
For our two-minute round.
15 minutes left filming.
Is that all?
15 minutes left filming.
You mean we've only been filming 5 stupid minutes?
Yes, yes.
I don't believe you.
Christ, this is so piggy, that stupid little cloud. It's killed me enough times, he has today.
He took it, and he's turning.
I'm only on the second lap with you.
He's only on the second lap.
Pathetic.
It's a bit pathetic.
Well, actually, I'm on the third lap now, see?
Third
lap. It is, it's really pathetic. I'm taking at least 30 seconds for each lap, so come on. I'm not that pathetic,
I don't know why he swallows a fly.
I did not swallow a stupid little fly, get it, little viewer?
Sorry about that,
viewers. Should have got an itchy nose. It's going to piss me off.
I'm shooting straight forward. Oh god, that's hard.
Well, that can't be bad. It's taking about 20 seconds for that lap. Oh, for some reason, I'm feeling
pissed off. Oh,
come on. Sorry. Oh, stupid little block.
We have run out of time for this program. See you next week.
No, we haven't!
La da da da. La da da da. Nintendo Hotline. Da 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 da. Remember, you'll be seeing Harry Clark.
Oh, yes. Do you want to know a little shortcut?
We
if you bounce into that little thing that fell down there 3 times, you get to the start a lot quicker. It's true, honestly, viewers.
Okay, let's go. Bye bye. Oh, let's just see this final lap.
Yes.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, shit. That was good. Did you know if you jump at the same time as you turn the corner, it's really decent. You skid better than when you... See? Didn't you see that? Watch this. I'm going to jump at the same time as I... Oh! See? It's decent, isn't it? I'm going to do that.
Okay, here we go. Da, 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 da.
No, just see what time I got, for God's sake, you stupid little boy. Oh, look, isn't that excellent? 30 seconds.
Three minutes.
Oh, bye-bye, you stupid...
Hello, my name's Alex. I'm going to do your...
Hello, and welcome to the Funky Tonk Dance. You might recognise the tune, but I don't know. Do you know this tune? 1, 2, 3, go.
I hope you're having a good time so far, because that's just the beginning. I hope you enjoyed that. Very much so fun, wasn't it? Bye bye.
Downstairs.
fast way. Do you remember this? This?
Can you see them?
No, they're not doing a pull yet, are they?
Just keep an eye on them, basically.
This is exciting, isn't it, viewers? Asleep. Don't go too close. Look at the spot. Oh my god. They go very good. Oh my god.
Can't see them clearly.
You can. You can when I get my head it. I'll look up some of the light.
Yep, there, I'm exactly right, so do not say anything. Yep, I've got them.
Well, but how do you make so realistic scenes? Like the amusement arcade that we saw in the last edition.
Oh,
and the Kringleford Park. Oh, how do you do it?
It's just my delightful technique of drawing.
Hey, but who drew who drew them? They were supposed to be really good. Was it you?
No, it wasn't. It was my very fellow annoyist who stands behind the camera and really pisses me off. Yes, it was him actually. He's really annoying. He wouldn't want to work.
I drew two of these. Anyway, now, if you want to do one of these endings, call me now. For you look everywhere. Yes, you do look on the floor. You might find my own books dancing girl everywhere. You might find a scene of a bank, you might find a scene of Kringleford Park, you might find Harry Clark or Mumbuck Stansinger himself. That would be worth £1 million if it was on television. Well, viewers, stay cool and remember, don't tell Mother. No, because if you guess what I'm doing now, you get a wobbly parrot. Yes, a wobbly parrot, like from Lion King. Okay, good night and sleep tight.
Marlenbush Dansinger was in his nice, warm, cosy home when he realised he wanted a book.
Again.
Again, yes, yet again. Marlenbush Stansinger has got bored of his old Pinocchio book and is going down the library. Through the trees of Kringleford Park, into the library. Marlenbush Stansinger got out a book and then he realised he didn't have any cash. He came out of the library, across to Barclays Bank. He took out £25. Out of the bank, way back to the library, Baron Bestanzinger said, "Oh, would it matter if I spent a few pounds at the amusement arcade?" And he plays on a slot machine and loses. Then he plays about 20 more times, and before he realized, he had no cash left. Comes out of the amusement arcade, the road to the bank, a couple more pound. Come out of the bank, into the library, himself a very good book called Pinocchio 2. Came out of the library, the trees of Kringleford Park, into the comfort of Maren Bestanzinger's very own home. Sat down a red Pinocchio 2 and lived happily ever after. One day, Maren Bestanzinger was going to the library, and he went past the trees of Kringleford Park and across the park to the library and bought a really good book called Pinocchio 3. He came out of the library and sat on a park bench, and he read his good book over and over again. Bestanzinger realized he had a cough, so he went to the chemist. Bestanzinger bought some cough syrup out of the chemist, went into the library because he got bored of his book. Maren Bestanzinger found a book, but then a man came up to him and said, "Oi, mate! Come to my county with me and I'll give you a quid." Maren Bestanzinger got to the back alley. This bloke said, "I'll give you cocaine for 500 quid. Maren Bestanzinger thought, "What on hell is cocaine?" Well, he bought it anyway because he thought it was a sweet worth millions of pounds. He tried it and figured out it was a drug. He went to the police. Bestanzinger told the police that there was a bloke who was giving away cocaine for 5 million quid. This gave Maren Bestanzinger a reward of £2 million for his telling on the world famous cocaine dealer. Maren Bestanzinger went through the trees of Kringleford Park, went back to the comfort of Maren Bestanzinger's very own home.
Well, hello, ladies and gentlemen, and I am the world famous highest clerk, and I am going to make myself disappear. Yeah, boom, 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 shit.
Hello.
Was the trick of Harris Clark, and you might see me tomorrow. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Wellbush Dancinger was in his nice, warm, cozy home when he realized he wanted a book.
Again,
yes, yet again, Wellbush Dancinger has got bored of his old Pinocchio book and is going down the library. Through the trees of Kringleford Park, one day Wellbush Dancinger went for a walk. Past the trees of Kringleford Park and across to the library. Wellbush Dancinger found a book called Pinocchio 2. He realized he had not got enough money. Wellbush Dancinger came out of the library and across the road to the bank. Wellbush Dancinger got out £25. He came out of the bank, across the road to the library. Wellbush Dancinger bought the book called Pinocchio 2. Wellbush Dancinger came out of the library, through the trees of Kringleford Park, back into the comfort of Wellbush Dancinger's very own home. Dancinger's very morning, Wellbush Dancinger went for a walk past the trees of Kringleford Park, across to the library. Wellbush Dancinger bought a book called Pinocchio 3. Wellbush Dancinger came out of the library and went to the games arcade in the mall. Spent £25 on slot machines. Out of the arcade, past the library, through the trees of Kringleford Park, back into the comfort of Wellbush Dancinger's very own home. One day, Wellbush Dancinger went for a walk. He went past the trees of Kringleford Park into the library. Wellbush Dancinger bought a book called Pinocchio, came out of the library, through the trees of Kringleford Park, back into the comfort of Wellbush Dancinger's very own home. Wellbush Dancinger realized he had a cough. He went back through the trees of Kringleford Park and across the road to the chemist. Wellbush Dancinger bought some cough syrup. Wellbush Stansinger came out of the chemist, but by this time it had started to rain. Mauer Stansinger ran back into the chemist to buy something for colds. He came out of the chemist through the trees of Kringleford Park back into the comfort of Mauer Stansinger's very own home.
Yeah, yeah.
You've seen Batman, you've seen Superman, but have you seen Big Trouble in Little China?
Buy your virtual pets at your local newsagents now, going for only 50p each.
If you buy a Tamagotchi, you get a few free True Lies video with it. Now for today's programme, it's time for Mauer Stansinger, the movie. One day, Mauer Stansinger was driving along in his car. Before now, he had become very good friends with the giants. He used to do the twist with his hand. Let's do the twist again. Ooh, like we did last year. And Mauer Stansinger was not afraid of his head anymore. Way!
Hello, Mauer Stansinger. How are you today? Oh, fine, thank you, Mr. Giant. How are you?
Well, said the giant, my wife left me today. And it was very hard for me. Anyway, I think you ought to be getting back home by now. But let's just have one last... one of those Superman jumps that we did last year. Well, let's do the twist again like we did last summer.
Alright.
Like we did last year. Let's do the twist. Let's do the twist again like we did last year. And after all that, Mauer Stansinger fainted. A long time after that, when Mauer Stansinger came back to Giantland, his wife and him were having a row because she'd just come back. And he was lying lazing about, eating food as fat as a pig. And suddenly, what happened? Ew! Mauer Stansinger was dead.
No!
What happened to Mauer Stansinger? He shall be buried here in this spot.
Expendables.
In a box. Let's just make the box. What you need to make a coffin for one of your dead friends or animals.
Here's one of these. What you do is you open it up.
You rip his legs off.
You take his legs off. And his arms. And then put him in as safe as can be. If you put him down and you bury him, I'll know where.
But what's this? Hello. But what's this? Hello. But what's this? Hello, I'm back. I wasn't really dead. It was a little giant and me trick. Well done. You went along with that really well. After that little joke they had, Mumba Stensinger decided to go home. But wait, he forgot to say goodbye to the viewers. Bye-bye, and remember, all you need is a box. Bye bye. Mumba Stansinger went back through the trees of Crick. Wait for Harry.
One day, Johnny went to the lavatory and Alex went to the front room. You go in. Don't let me catch you on the camera.
Just get in there! You've got to get in there! You're not allowed to look unless you get in there.
Oh, you're no looking, you've got to be in there. Right, you're in there now.
Gotcha. Gotcha.
Yes, you're on video!
How the hell did you know?
Ladies and gentlemen. Right, Alex, do you want to do one?
Yeah, I'm going to get you.
We've just got to wait till Harry comes in.
Hi, Alex.
button.
I'm going to tidy up in my coffin.
Yay!
Come in.
Morning in Cringleford Park. A meteor came to Earth. People gathered round it. They had no idea what it was.
Oh, what could this meteor be? Oh!
Shit.
I wonder what it is. I'm going to do some tests on it to see what it is.
So the man did some tests and found out that it was no meteor. Oh no, it was hollow. People were coming and going to see the great meteor that had come from the moon. They still had no idea what it is, but in the middle of the night, something happened. People from all over the globe came to see it. They realized it was War of the Worlds 2.
Hoo 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 hoo.
a man came along to have a look at it. But before he knew it,
he had been zapped by the alien spaceship's laser. Zing, zang, zong!
The next morning, a man came along to find the two men dead. He told them all his friends, and they just died of shock. Then he realized that no longer was the vacuum cleaner poking out of the top of the meteor. Oh no, it was on the loose already, and it was heading towards the city. In the cities, people were fleeing because of the great big Martian spaceship machine which was coming their way. People in the city had no idea how to kill the Martian invaders. So in the end, they thought of using some nowadays technology, the nuclear bomb. All going crazy because they knew the nuclear bomb would land at any time. The nuclear bomb exploded. The mighty power of the nuclear bomb spread throughout all the cities in the country, and to find out what had happened to the UFOs. Fortunately for some people, the aliens were not destroyed. They were still flying around the cities, causing disaster. Zig, 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 zig! The alien's laser shot the cities dead.
2, 1. Right up.
Boys!
No! All it says is you are reading this.
Did you stop it for me? Oh, well done. Put it back on there.
Mom. Oh, it's finished now.
Oh, no, I want to see it from the beginning. I want to see it right from the beginning.
Oh, you what? Should see the first
Gil
one.
Gilbert's longing to see it now.
That is really totally good.
Well, no, save that one for when Gilbert's here, because he wants to see some with you.
Oh, please, can you see the first one?
Can I just see the one about the babysitter that I just watched?
Oh, can you watch one before?
No, because then I'll spoil it when I'm watching the Gilbert.
Oh, can I just tell you something that happened?
Well, no, why don't we all watch it together? He's longing to see it.
When's he coming?
He'll be coming tomorrow.
Oh, that's the boringest one.
No,
please,
I want to watch the one about the babysitters. Let me
okay,
see.
Okay, fast forward, Harry.
Are there three on? Is there three or two on, I think?
You've got to fast forward, Harry. Well, you've got to tell you what happened. And there's this person in the church saying, because Homer spotted an alien. Because when another life form came to Earth and died again, but didn't die, E.T. I love that little guy.
Oh yeah, in this one it's really okay. Decent. He says, I wish God would help me, and then the phone.
Okay, go back.
Shouldn't be much further.
Okay.
Now.
Watch it from here, because it's the beginning. In this sweet place, earthly donuts are sour as poison. You spit them out, you would. I'm talking about the candy industry trade show. Mum, I'm gonna go and get some sorbet for mine. Every million Krusty Krab bar and Krusty Krab bar with almonds.
Hey! I have asked you nicely not to mangle my merchandise. You leave me no choice but to ask you nicely again.
Sorry, kids, but this is the one event I want my darling wife by my side.
Look at you,
Homer.
But take one of the kids.
Of course, they can't carry enough candy. They have puny little muscles, not big, ropey ones like you.
You go, Mom, for the greater good. For the greater good.
Once you knocked him over.
He's done a wheelchair.
Alex, just get over there.
No.
You're trying to piss me off.
No, I'm not.
I'm just sit quiet.
Shut up!
Condemned criminals dig at each other with rusty hooks.
Mm-hmm. Do a little housework and you can play for 5 minutes.
No way.
Feelings of nails aren't hard to take. They all follow their video cartridges.
Oh.
In some kind of a store. Yeah. Right. Ooh-wee. Expressive. Ooh, you do well. Give me another.
Well, as you can see, I have created a weather ball so sour it can only be safely contained in a magnetic field. The candy known as 77X42 is great. Where the hell is the candy?
I don't know.
Hey, sir, try our wax lips. It's the candy of 1,000 uses.
Like what?
One, a humorous substitute for your own lips.
Keep going.
Two, Ooh, I'm needed in the basement.
You're gonna have to put some sugar on that celery or get out, man.
Ooh, gummy bears! Gummy calves heads! Gummy jawbreakers! Hop, hop.
This is... Actually, I won't tell ya.
What?
That is the rarest gummy of the all! The gummy bears de Mayo! Carved by gummy artisan Hoover Explosive!
Oi, you sod, I can't see ya! Did you lick the screen?
How long we got?
Well, let's have a look at how my time... Shit, he's changed. I'm going to show you, though. Look, there he is. He's on the telly.
No, he hasn't.
He was on the telly. You missed him.
No, he hasn't changed.
He has, obviously.
He's going to beak.
What's he done that's so amusing?
Now, he's in the poop.
He's done a poo, viewers. Let's see him clean it up. Let's do the twist. Alex!
He hasn't changed.
He has, honestly. Oh, shit. Did you reset him?
No. Mum's coming.
This is my closed-circuit
television I needed left.
Oh, look, here he comes. It's Mr. Steven Lace with a penis.
Ah, shit. Pete! See! See! See!
Range reverse.
Right, go back.
Oh, she's a stupid...
She can't run fast.
And then she can't sit back. This time we're going to have a different angled video cam. It's going to be angled across the hall.
Am I allowed to see what it can see?
Yep.
You're allowed to see what it can see. Is that where you're going to get past?
Where's Cleaner? We're
in stage one. Goodbye, here I come.
Insurance. Oh yes, and I can still have a loan.
Oh, yes. Just by calling 0800 200 300. Oh, yes. And I suppose you'll have to have loads of forms to fill in. Oh, no. And I can still settle my car insurance. Oh, yes. Cool. But Churchill's now on 0800 300 200. Thank you.
Oh no! My dog's done a poo on the floor again!
Don't worry, ma'am. Now we have got new antiperspirant spray. If you're in trouble, it will save the day. It's brave and it's fearless, come what may. It will take your dog poop away. Introducing new Ohnahiha.
Hello there, gentlemen. This is Mrs. Thomas, as you can probably see. Sing.
Ha ha!
always losing your lives. If you punch the butterflies, you may not believe me in this, but they do actually turn into worms. We'll try as much as we can to actually punch them. It needs a lot of practice. We'll just get another bunch of butterflies for you in the flowers at the other side. I'm afraid that I'm about to have a go because my sister doesn't seem to do it. As you can see, we've completed this level. We are now showing you one of the biggest secrets of all. The secret place of Yoshi. But you have to have 120 power stars for that cannon actually to go there to open it up. It's Yoshi! Mario, is that really you? It has been so long since our last adventure. They told me that I might see you if I waited here, but I'd just about given up hope. Is it true? Have you really beaten Bowser and restored the stars to the castle and saved the princess? I knew you could do it. Now I have a very special message for you. Thanks for playing Super Mario 64. This is the end of the game, but not the end of the fun. The Super Mario 64 team. We get 100, yes, I repeat, 100 lives. And that is the secret place of Yoshi. As well as this, we'll just show you what else Yoshi gives you. He gives you an extra... bouncy jump. So if you do a triple jump, you actually bounce on the ground once. And if you do a triple jump and fall off, it doesn't actually hurt you. We go
going up here again. Don't know why at the moment. I think we're going to get the wing cap. Yes, I was right. I'm going to show you a nice trick that I've been trying to perform all day. I might get it wrong if I do, please don't laugh. I need to start it up the top again to do it right though. So I'm just getting it back into the canyon.
Are you going to try to go through that wall?
Oh, you are, aren't you? I'm not trying to go through that wall. This isn't actually a trick I've been trying to learn all day. This is the trick that I just made up that I thought you might want to see. That wasn't it. I've got to start again because I actually did that a bit wrong. Sorry about that. But I'm going to have to do it a different way this time. I will not use what I was going to use. I used to use. I will now use advanced stuff.
Oh, you're crap at this, have you noticed?
That was just my associate being jealous because I'm better than him.
Jealous? Well, I know what we ought to do. We ought to do one level each and ask Mum to see if he's there. I'll tell
him. Honey, we are recording.
Oh yeah, it's a good idea.
Okay, up we go. Shoot up here. Acrobatic session. Ooh, that was close, eh, there? That
you
was close.
Are so crap!
Now, this is the end of this game, because at the moment I'm just losing consciousness. To have a girlfriend, I'm going. Now it is time for Big Boo the Bollocks. Hey, I didn't make up these words.
I'm Big Boo, I'm Big Boo, I'm scaring you. I'm Big Boo, I'm I'm Big Boo, I'm Big Boo, and I do need a poo, and I'm Big Boo, I'm Big Boo, I'm Big Boo, many years, oh shit, Big Boo, Big Boo, I am Big
Harry,
Bat,
stop, stop now, I want to stop, come on.
Hello. Hello, and we have Johnny Depp with the Johnny Depp map.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Open up. Gonna get it might be
your nose is red as me. And a diamond. No one knows what a diamond does mean till I tell them it means love at first sight. Ha ha. I know my but don't worry, I am still here as a puppet. My puppet friends are gonna speak to you now. Bye, see you in a little.
Hello, my name's Ted. Hello, mine's Bob. Let's go, Ted. I'd like to go to the cinema. All right, Bob, let's go.
Wait a minute, Bob. How are they going to get there?
With a little walk, can't she?
Yeah, but they can't walk.
Why is that?
Because it is a restricted area for hands. You're not allowed to go around with hands there.
It is restricted? I did not know that.
Now, children, let's go in a cab.
Hey, we can't use a cab either. They don't like cabs either.
Let's go by dolphin. Hey, we made it to the cinema, Bob.
That's good.
Let's go, Bob. On to the cinema we go.
That's nearly all of me. But I just like to say.
We're recording, for Christ's sake!
To my feet.
They call Bob.
Hello, Bob. How are you?
Hello, Fred. How are you?
All apart to take the door. What are the dogs?
Sorry, they've got a mechanical injury. It's an ancient tradition, but remember, for me and all the team, peace are what, my god?
Is this all
down to
Lani?
What?
No way, I
could
see
a
single.
Now, it's time to my friend, who you can see in that picture there.
Hello.
He's going to do, she's going to do one. I don't know what it's called.
Right. Hello. My name's Eric Kaufman, and I know a funky song. I learned it last night. It's called Jingle Bell Rock. Oh, jingle bell, jingle bell, jingle bell rock. Jingle, swing, and jingle bells ring. Snowing and blowing, she's a fun. Now the jingle bell has begun. Jingle bell, jingle bell, jingle bell.
Said that if you two have expanded from your bedrooms, there will be trouble. Do you understand?
What do you mean expanded?
Well, if you've made a mess anywhere but in your bedrooms. Okay.
Stop.
Well, don't tell me the story. This is that you actually interfered with stuff.
How?
My clothes.
I might show you that in a minute, but this is really hard, this one. This is the last Bowser course. The Bowser's not that hard, is it? But this time you've got to hit him three times on the mines instead of once. And every time he breathes on fire, it stays in the same position. Again, you can collect 8 red coins, but at the moment I'm not planning to do that. That's a cheat. If you didn't do that, it might take a minute longer. But I don't want you to be obsessed with cheating on this game.
It's a very good game.
Because what's the point in playing a game if you're going to cheat? Leave all those coins there for if you fall off.
that was something you're not meant to do, but you're meant to wait till the fire goes.
Oh, look,
it's one of those hearts.
Yeah.
Well, look, it's one of those hearts. Yes, it's on the hearts. We'll just get that.
Oh, shit.
Oh, no, I fell down, but don't worry. I'm back here. I know you recognise it. That's why I saved some of the coins. Just for reasons like this. Okay, anyway, I only need one coin. But I took two. But don't worry. Woohoo!
If you pound
on the ground, it saves some of your health. Sometimes. So. If you leave it for a long time, Mario begins to get tired and he sits down. Then if you leave it for even longer, he lies down. And he goes and he goes to sleep. And he starts saying, "Ah, salata, spaghetti, salata, and ravioli.
Ah, mamma mia.
Ah, mamma mia. Ah, lovely."
We'll show you that later.
But we'll show you that later. Anyway, just nearly at the Bowser now. Close, I nearly fell down there. This is one of the hardest bits of the course. Now we're at the Bowser. I just need to get through this wind.
It's a half to go.
Never jump, otherwise that happens. This might be a very hard bad, so I might die on this.
Once or twice.
But I like to think that it shouldn't be that hard because I've got all the power stars and I've got more power and he's a bit weaker. Okay. He's the same, really. I just need to do that to get him a bit closer to one of these. I always do that to get him a bit closer. Don't worry, I should make him hit one. Now, one down. As you can see, he didn't land on his back. So that's a very bad sign. So that means he isn't actually dead yet. As you can see, I just got hit then.
Very bad, please.
I think Bowser should learn some manners, don't you? Anyway. I just got hit again. If I get hit one more time by Bowser, I'm going to be dead. But don't worry, I won't get hit. I just died then. I told you I might die once or twice.
One minute to go. Hurry up.
Okay, I
shouldn't take that long.
Barely any time left.
Okay, I'll be really quick now, because as I see, the time is running out on this tape. So, round we go, and up and sweep, filling a big black bag. Then they tiptoe to the window, off with the swag.
Barely any time left.
This is barely any time left. He just breathed something, but don't fret. I just got hit. But
time is nearly dead.
But I'm going to try and complete this as quick as I can.
Hurry up! Less than 30 seconds if that.
Okay. I might just have to hit him once because we definitely haven't got much time left. I've got to zoom to get to
come on.
Time is money. I just try. But as I cannot tell you how you complete him or what you have to do to complete him, this remains really a secret. So I must stop the tape there. Okay, off my mate.
Okay, we'll go.
Let's go. Hello, my friends. Today we don't want all you beginners out there. This is not a video for you. We are only doing master and pro spinners. We are just the bomb. We do not care about you novices who can't yo-yo. We are for the masters. Okay, my brother here. Yes, him. He is going to do 3D clover. Watch carefully.
Okay, now to the trick, you need to use the loop the looping method. Roll up, up and down.
Yes, that's right, my friends. Up, out and down.
Okay, for my next trick, Alex is going to do double spin the cat.
Okay, for this trick, you need a sleeper. If you can just sleep where you've got two, if you've got that's a stupid yo-yo that it can't sleep. That's your fault. Get a new one. Okay, dog skin the cat. Finger hop. Back twice and out. That's right. Finger hop. Back and out. And if you don't know what finger hop is, look at this trick again.
Okay,
my friend here is going to do warp drive.
Warp drive is a very advanced trick for those very advanced people. Okay, now you've got to start off with a round roll, which I bet everyone knows how to do. Then I bet you've got to, and everyone knows how to do a loop. Now to do warp drive, you need to do a loop to a row. Whoops, I just skidded there, you know. You've got to do a... like that. And now Paul's going to show you a trick called trapeze.
Yes, this is trapeze. And as you can see, I am in the centre of the screen. And not over here. Okay, trapeze. You start off with a breakaway and put your finger in between and catch it on the string. And if you don't catch it on the string, for some stupid reason, take it out, get it on your middle finger and flip it back. So trapeze. Okay, now I am going to do double or nothing. It's a lot like trapeze. You start with another breakaway. You put your finger in between once, twice and out, and then spin it out. There's a lot of ways to go out, but that's my favourite way. Now my brother is going to do barrel rolls.
Okay, you know now people, okay, alright, I understand it, and I also need to see the skill. Okay, throw a sleeper. Do a split bottom mount, you do a somersault, you do one, two, three, and then you do an out. Wasn't that a very simple trick, viewers? Now I'm going to do a trick called brain twister. It's very unadvanced, For a sleeper, scoop up the yo-yo with string, flip it somersault forward, and a somersault out in a loop. Okay, now everyone's going to try critical split the hours rather advanced, you know.
This is one of the most advanced string tricks you ever learned, so I'll go on the slide for you. Okay, you start off, you get a split bottom out, do one of them. Okay, so you get a split bottom out, do one of them. Half a barrel roll, onto that, one of them, out, and loop. That's right, I'll just repeat that for you. Up onto that. And there's a lot of ways you can advance it, and I'm just going to quickly do an advanced method. Okay? One of them. Not into one of them. Into one of them. To rock the baby. Into that one. I can't be bothered to show you that actually. And now I'm going to do reach for the moon for you, my friend. So you've got to tighten up your yo-yo so it bounces off the ground. I'm going to kneel for this trick so you can see all the detail of it. Okay, so you go up and out. If you start with your forward path, and you go up and out, and up and out, and up and out. Okay, the thing with this trick is do not move your hand up like that, because that's not very messy, just do a little flick. Okay, now my brother's going to show you hop the fence.
Yeah, boy, wasn't that very boring? And it's a trick called hop the fence. Starts with the yo-yo throw down, you put it down and you just flip over the front of the yo-yo. You keep doing that 10 whole times. Okay? That's about 10 if you ask me. Okay, now I'm going to show you a trick called loops, which...
Ow!
I'm going to use this yo-yo called a pita fish for. They're very good for looping because they've got a very high outer edges, which means they can't go off centre, which we all have a tendency to do. Start with forward pass, stick your fingers in and loop it out. You have to do, first one is always a forward pass, as you remember, and each loop has got to be absolutely perfectly straight like these. Wasn't that beautiful, boys and girls? Now let's go on to pro spinning yo-yoing.
Pro. Yes, pro. And now my brother is still in there. H-bomb, my friend.
Okay, firstly, I'm going to have to get rid of this yo-yo yet again. Okay, now, I'm going to have to use my wiper. Okay, you put this on your finger, like you do with most tricks. You loosen it a bit so it sleeps like a good yo-yo. No! You know, remember that trusty old breakaway? Okay. For a breakaway, you've got to go like this. You've got to do a backwards spin. Did you see that, boys and girls? That's the beginning of the hydrogen bomb. Now, to do it properly, you've got to go like this. Backwards barrel rolls. And then a double out like you split the atom. Okay, now it's time for... Oh, yeah. Now... I'm going to have to do a trick called two-handed loops. Ow! Here comes another yo-yo. Where did it come from? I wonder. Firstly, for this, I'm going to need to do a little adjusting. So switch to tape off, please. Well, hello there. As you see, I've got two yo-yos using for two-handed loops. Ha! You know, this is a very complicated trick. Can you remember those loops that we did? 15 of them. Now I'm going to have to do two. Two-handed five loops. Okay, just give them one, two, three, three. Now, you know, I may not get this right first time because it's a very complicated trick. You have to loop with both hands simultaneously. So, I'm going to try it, okay? Okay, as you see, that didn't go desperately well. But I'm going to have another go, otherwise I'll get fired. Okay. Oh, that was rather good, but it still wasn't fine. Now my brother's coming on with another trick.
Yes, my friend! I'm going to do a trick called Bird's Nest, but this is a very, very complicated trick, my friend. So, I'm going to have to get this ready. Okay. So, we start off with our trusty, what's it called again? Reach for the moon. Yes, I'm glad you remembered.
Okay? So you start off with a reach for the moon. When you do that, you put your thumb in the way and open your thumb up halfway through when it goes off. So open it up and the yo-yo has got to land like that. And then you go out and catch. Okay, I'm going to try this now. As you can see, that was not very successful, so I'll try it again. And that was perfectly clean, out and catch. Okay, now my brother's going to do a trick, I think.
I am, and everyone, it's called loops. Alex, okay, this is Dirty Loops. It's very complicated, but you know I'm a pro. Cool, go on! Okay, Dirty Loops, here we go. One, two, three. 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30. Wasn't that very clean, boys and girls? Now, my brother's going to do the next trick. I wonder what it's called.
This trick, you know our trusty reach for the moon. This is reach for the moon, times 5, yes. Okay, so you start off with a 1. A 2, a 3, a 4, and a 5. That wasn't very clean, but we've got to do it much cleaner. So it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Oh, and catch! You've got to really perfect it. So if I was you, I'd just keep going 1, 2, and just keep practicing 1, 2. But now I think my brother's going to come on with a decent trick.
Okay, everybody, I know you can't see me, but I'm very skilled. Woo, look at that. Bet you were surprised there. Okay, now my next trick, I'm going to have to get on my knees for. Do you remember those loop-de-loops? Yes, I guess who's getting a bit tired of them now. But now I've got to do some vertical loops. To do them, we start off with Alex's old trusty reach for the moon. When you get up, though, you keep looping upwards, like this. Like that, you see? Very complicated trick this, but I reckon in a couple of days of practice you'll be able to do about 50 of them in a second. Let me just have one more go at that. Ah, see, they were rather nice then, but still it didn't work very well. But now we've got a very complicated trick done by my brother where we're gonna have to go outside.
So if you would stop the tape please, my mate.
I know you can't hear him very well, but he's about to do a trick called Texas Cowboy. And here he goes. Oh, that was just a practice. Thought he was doing something then. Ah, wow. Did you see that? Wasn't it very skilled? He's going to do it again for us. And yes, he does. He's very skilled. Now, if you would like to come in, come in.
What?
Okay, now. Where's my yo-yo, Mr. Man? Oh, look. It's another viper. Vipers are very useful in this video, you know. Okay, we are now here's a trick called Milk the Cow. It's slightly like Up the Fence, except you've got to do it with both hands and you've got to do it hop 3 times. So let's have a go. Oh, that was pretty bad. I mean, pretty good, but not good enough. Let's just have one last go. Ow! Okay, as you
You know, I've contributed to the NHS all my life and I really haven't used it very much, and when I need it, it just isn't there.
The government wants the NHS to provide the kind of treatment the O'Connells had to pay for. Expectations have been raised that this is what Labour will deliver, but there are severe doubts over whether it can produce the reforms and the money that's required.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Thanks to us.
Terry Dignan reporting there. Well, the Health Secretary, Alan Milburn, is in our Newcastle studio. Good afternoon, Mr. Milburn.
Good afternoon, John.
Can we clear up this thing about the commitment to achieving the European average of spending by 2005? Are we committed to that or are we not?
Yes, that's precisely what we're aiming to do, and we're making good progress towards it.
The European average at the moment, I think, is around 7.9% of GDP across the European Union nations. We reckon that by 2003-04 we'll be at around 7.6%. So we're well on target to reaching that eventual aim.
The reason I asked the question, though, as you'll know, is that Mr. Blair said on Wednesday in the House of Commons, straightforwardly, in answer to a question from Charles Kennedy, are we committed? He said, of course. This morning, in The Independent on Sunday, to whom he gave an interview, he said, I'm not deciding the spending levels now, but in broad terms, we've got to match other European countries. Now, those are two very different answers, aren't they?
No, I don't think they are, actually, because there's a process underway here. Tony set out on the Frost programme a year or so ago what our eventual aim was, which was to get up to European levels of spending on average. That's what we need to do, and indeed the OneList report published just last week confirms what we all know, that we've had healthcare on the cheap for too long in this country, that we lag way behind in terms of spending, and therefore some of the outcomes in healthcare that Liam Fox was talking about earlier. And therefore, we need to bridge that gap, and we can do that over time. We're actually the fastest growing healthcare system of any country, major country in Europe right now. That's because of the extra levels of investment that are going in. There's a lot of catching up to do, but as I say, by the end of the 2003-04 financial year, we will be at around 7.6% of GDP. Compared to an average of 7.9%. And then for 2003-04 and forward to 2006, we'll be considering these issues in the spending review process that is now underway,
right,
informed, helpfully, by what Mr. OneList will come up with by the time of Gordon's budget next year.
Yeah, indeed. But two small problems with that. One is you use the word aim. Mr. Blair used the word commitment in the House of Commons on Wednesday. And the other word...
Terribly hung up on that.
I think it's terribly important to you, because if I just finish that point, you said aim and you said eventually. Now, it was much more specific with Mr. Blair than that, wasn't it? He said there is a commitment to reach that figure by 2005, financial year 2005. There is a big difference there.
That's what we're seeking to do, John.
But is it a commitment?
That is what we're seeking to do. That is what we want to do. Yes, that is what we want to do. And Tony set that out again in the House of Commons this week and made the more, I think, important general point that there's no such thing as a free lunch when it comes to healthcare. And what OneList usefully describes, in my view, is the fact that, first of all, we've lagged way behind. Secondly, he assesses what is necessary in order to meet the demands on the National Health Service. And then thirdly, we will have to decide what levels of investment we need to put into the NHS over a period of time to get up to European levels of expenditure, right, and hopefully continue to grow the National Health Service, not just for a few years, but for many decades. And in the end, there are only one or two or maybe three ways of financing that gap. Either we do it through general taxation, or we do it through social insurance systems like they have in France and Germany, or you get, as Liam Fox seemed to be indicating, the Conservative position, that is that more and more people will have to pay for more and more aspects of their healthcare. One thing is absolutely clear. Whatever happens, if we're going to have a healthcare system in our country and a National Health Service that is up with the best in Europe rather than behind the rest, then somewhere or other we're going to have to pay for it. And sometimes this is presented, in my view, as if, you know, through general taxation you're going to have to pay more, but through some other system it all comes for free. It doesn't.
Well, exactly.
What we've got to decide is what is the best way forward in order to get up to European levels of funding and to give our people genuinely a healthcare system that is amongst the best in the world.
But what you said in that answer was the best. The truth is, surely, isn't it, that you're not going to be happy with merely the European average, because, of course, averages have good countries and then bad countries. And what you want is that we should match the very best, whether it's France or Germany or Sweden. That's the objective, isn't it?
Well, I think that's what people in this country will be looking for. But what they will also know is that for decades and decades and decades, our spending on the National Health Service, on healthcare generally in this country, has lagged way behind. So we've got to take this one stage at a time. As I say, we are now putting more money in. That is beginning to bite in the National Health Service. And you can see that with the extra doctors, the extra nurses. This year, for the first time in 30 years in this country, we're actually increasing the number of beds in hospitals. They've been cut back for 30 years, and now they're rising. You're getting the waiting times down for the heart operations. We're making good progress, actually, on getting the waiting times more generally down for hospital operations. But we can only continue to sustain that if, for the long term, we're prepared to put in sustainable and rising levels of investment. And that is precisely precisely what we are committed to doing.
And they will have to rise considerably, won't they, if we are talking about matching the best, because Germany at the moment, 10.6% of GDP, France, 9.6%, Britain, 6.7%. Those are the World Bank figures. So there is a great yawning gap to make up there, isn't there?
There is. There's a huge gap to make up. And I don't think anybody other than a fool or a madman really believes that a few years of extra spending going into the National Health Service, which is what is happening now, can reverse decades of underspending in the National Health Service. It takes years to train the doctors and the nurses, to build the new hospitals. We've got a huge hospital building program going on right now, actually the biggest that the National Health Service has ever seen. But it takes some time for these things to produce results. Sure. I think what is interesting about the one-list figures, actually, although people talk about the gap between our level of private spending and our compared to French or German levels of private spending, actually, if you analyse the gap very closely between UK spending and German and French spending, you will see actually that the biggest proportion of that gap is made up by underinvestment through public spending.
Well, exactly.
In the case of both France and Germany. And it is that we're beginning to put right now with the National Health Service, as I say, growing at a much faster rate than other major European countries' healthcare systems. But heaven knows, there is a huge gap to make up.
And that's the question I wanted to address, because clearly a lot more public spending needed. Now, the question is how that money is raised. We're supposed to be having a debate about this, and I wanted to check with you, I suppose, whether that debate is still open. That's to say, is there still a debate, a genuine debate, aiming to arrive at a consensus, as to whether that extra public spending is raised through general taxation or a hypothecated, that hideous word, hypothecated ring-fenced tax. Is that debate still open?
Yes, it is. We're going to have a debate. But we're having a debate now. You've had Liam on your programme earlier. The newspapers today are full of debate about this issue. I think where the point of consensus lies, John, although I wasn't terribly clear from Liam Fox's answer that this was the Conservative commitment, I think there is now a recognition in this country that for decades we've had healthcare on the cheap, that the National Health Service and the brilliant people who work in it have been short-changed, and that what we now need to do is not just get the investment in, but undertake some pretty far-reaching and fundamental reforms to ensure that we get the very best value for money for the extra investment that is going in. That is the debate that needs to take place, and I personally believe that we should be very confident about the position that Gordon set out last week in the House of Commons, that if there is a debate to be had about what is the best method of raising extra funds for the National Health Service, then actually raising money through general taxation has much going for it. And I think what Liam Fox and Ian Duncan-Smith will find as they undertake their trips through Europe is that actually there are very many downsides to the social insurance system. It lowers extra costs on employers and on jobs. The big concern in both France and Germany from the employers' federations there is that actually these amount to taxes on labour mobility and productivity, and that the best and fairest way actually of raising money for a country's health system is probably through general taxation. But let's have the debate.
And as far as you're concerned, that debate, as I say, is still open. The possibility of an hypothecated tax has not been ruled out, and that debate is happening not just in the newspapers and on this programme, but within the Cabinet as well.
Well, I think I watched Gordon this morning on the Frost programme, and he quite rightly said that there is a debate to be had about all these issues. I think we've got to get this right in terms of how this
goes. I thought he'd rather shut down the hypothecated version, actually, from his point of view. Did I misread him there?
Sorry?
I thought he'd rather close down the possibility of an hypothecated tax himself.
I think what he said is that there is a very important debate to be had, first of all, about assessing the level of demands and the challenges that the National Health Service will face. And I suppose that is the first part of the one-list report, which he's now produced. Secondly, we need to consider how best to close that gap, and indeed what level of funding will be required to do so. And finally, we've got to set out a very clear programme, not just of extra investment going into the NHS, but some big structural reforms to make sure that we have a service that is much more responsive to the needs of the patient and gets good value for money for the taxpayer.
Yes, because we're putting in billions more now, as you say, and it doesn't really seem to be making a great deal of difference to people's experience of the NHS, does it?
I don't think that's true, actually. Of course, look, there are real problems in the National Health Service. Nobody denies that. I say that in every interview I do with you and other people, John. But there are very real signs of progress, too. We've got the biggest hospital building programme underway. We've got 17,000 more nurses. We've got 7,000 more doctors. More beds this year for the first time in 30 years. We're spending this year alone around £250 million on new and improved drugs. Prescribing of...